What are the chances Brian Harsin succeeds in the SEC? What are the chances that Harsin succeeds in year one? Welcome to the Voice of College Football SEC as we are breaking down the win probabilities for each team in the conference. All right, let's break it down for the Auburn Tigers under Brian Harsin. Of course, they went 6-5 with a bowl loss to Northwestern last season. We are going from the highest probability win to the lowest. So we, of course, go to some of the week non-conference games that Auburn will be playing at home, starting with Alabama State. That's on September 11th, the second game of the season. Auburn's just about guaranteed to win that game. Let's give it 99% chance of winning. Okay, then against the Akron Zips, perennially one of the worst teams in the MAC. Let's go 98% on this one. A step up from Alabama State is Akron slightly. Not even a full step, 98%. That's the opening game of the season. Akron and Auburn have met once in their respective histories. That was back in 1988. Tigers won it 42-0. Georgia State, out of the Sun Belt, a little bit better team. That game's coming up September 25th, but again, Auburn an overwhelming favorite at home on the Plains. At 94%. All right, let's jump into the SEC, and the percentages will, of course, go down. Auburn brings back plenty of talent, but certainly plenty of question marks, and won't have the dominant defensive front we would expect this season that they've had the past 5, 6, 7 years. That could show up certainly in many of these games. Mississippi State's a team that they beat last season 24-10, and they face the Bulldogs and Mike Leach on November 13th. And Mississippi State had the big opening game under Mike Leach in his first season against LSU on the road, defeating the defending national champions. Then they went on a horrible slide, only beat Vanderbilt for a long time, rallied late, beat a good Tulsa team in the bowl game in Mississippi State. Again, second season under Mike Leach. Maybe he starts to get things revved up. But home game, Mississippi State, give Auburn a 73% chance of winning this one. The next week, Auburn goes to South Carolina. No Will Muschamp, Shane Beamer taking over after Muschamp turned in a 2-8 season, but that 2-8 included an upset win at home against Auburn, in which the Gamecocks came back to win that game 30-22. Again, the two teams meet the second to last weekend of the season leading into the Iron Bowl. Even on the road, give Auburn a 70% chance of beating South Carolina. On to the Arkansas game, which happens on October 16th, that game on the road for Auburn. We know what happened, the controversy on the Plains last season. What would have happened at the end, we don't know. But we know that the officials pretty much blew it and set up Auburn with the game-winning field goal. Arkansas is much improved. We saw that last season under Sam Pittman. They still finished at 3-7, but they had a couple really ridiculous losses, the one to Auburn in particular. Auburn won at 30-28. The Tigers have beaten the Hogs 5 consecutive times. They've won 7 of the last 8 in the series. Give them a 57% chance of winning on the road. Ole Miss is at home, and again, this was a barn burner, a game in which Auburn could have easily lost. It was a controversial finish as well. Ole Miss finished strong. They beat Indiana late in the bowl game. Auburn's going to be at home for this game. I think it's generally a toss-up. I would say that Ole Miss is actually a slight favorite, but we're projecting months and months ahead, of course. But since it's at home, give Auburn the 53-47 advantage over Ole Miss. And the Tigers have downed the Rebels 5 straight, and they are 7-1 in their last 8 meetings against the Rebels. One of the better non-conference matchups, both in terms of a 2021 matchup and also historically, is Auburn going to Happy Valley to take on Penn State for the first in a home-and-home series with James Franklin and company. Penn State had finished in the top 15 in the country 4 consecutive years, 3 of those in the top 10 with New Year's 6 bowl appearances, but they fell on hard times with 5 consecutive losses to start 2019, rallied with 4 wins, looked better, of course, finishing at 4-5. These two squads last met in bowl games, of course. Not necessarily, of course, but the SEC and the Big Ten don't get together much in the regular season, and they have the big bowl matchups in Florida. That being the 2003 Capital One Bowl, slugfest between two top 10 teams, and Penn State won it, or I'm sorry, Auburn won that game in 03, 13-9. 9 years earlier at the Outback Bowl, Penn State bludgeoned Auburn 43-14. Again, toss-up game for me right here as we stand 6 months in advance, but it's on the road, so give Penn State the 56-44 edge over the Auburn Tigers. LSU had one of its worst performances last year in a dismal season at 5-5 in losing to Auburn 48-11. But this year, the Tigers have to go to Death Valley to take on the LSU Tigers. LSU should bounce back, be a much better team. Auburn struggled in this series as of late at 4-10 in the last 14 years. Give Auburn a 36% chance of winning this one in Death Valley. Next up would be Georgia, arguably the best roster in the country, somewhere in that range of the top 3-4. JT Daniels has positioned himself as the quarterback, and Georgia should be able to make an SEC championship game run. They finished at 8-2 last year. That included a 27-6 win over Auburn early, and the Tigers have had a rough time with their rivals in the South's oldest rivalry, 2-9 in the last 11 years. Give Auburn a 35% chance of beating Georgia games at home. Texas A&M, emerging as one of the top teams in the country, finished fourth in the final AP poll at 9-1. They beat Auburn 31-20, a game that went back and forth, and then finally Texas A&M was the better team in the fourth quarter. Auburn is 4-3 against the Aggies since Texas A&M joined the SEC in 2012. But again, the Aggies won it by 11 last year. The two teams meet in November on the first weekend of the month. It's on the road. Give Auburn a 31% chance of defeating Texas A&M. Aggies 69% pick here. And then finally, Alabama, the juggernaut, should be ready to go despite all the changes on offense with skill position players and a quarterback. 13-0 national champions. Nobody really challenged them outside of Ole Miss gave them a scare. Florida to a certain extent. 42-13. Gus Malzahn had a nice run against Bama. Won 3 of 7 games, which against Nick Saban's remarkable. But was sent on his way with a 42-13 blowout loss to the Tide. And Auburn's got this one at home, but give the Tigers just a 16% chance of defeating the Tide on the last day of the season in what could be argued as the greatest rivalry in college football. So our percentages, match them up against yours. Let us know where we missed it down below in the comment section. And we'll be back with more win probabilities. And certainly give us your requests on videos as we cover the SEC every day here at the Voice of College Football, SEC.